Now it is time for another round of our Mom Squad, and even though we're still in July, the back-to-school rush, it's already here with an onslaught of sales, social media ads, even school emails. I've received them myself, and it begs the question, are we losing the summer experience with all this early planning for fall? Well, here to help us savor the summer with our children before they return to class is lifestyle journalist and mother of two, Amy E. Goodman. Good to see you.
Yes, delighted to be here with you.
You and I were just talking, though. It's so crazy, though, because I feel like summer is flying by.
It seems to fly by a little faster each summer, and I don't know if it's because we overpack our schedules. We feel like there's so much to get done with the kids, as a family, trying to also balance work, however you define work. And I also got the back-to-school email from the school just 2 days ago for high school. I'm waiting for the one from middle school, so I have a high schooler and a middle schooler. It seems like they're reaching out earlier and earlier each year, summer.
You know, it's interesting, too, because it's also hard to totally, and I think specifically in our area, embrace the summer vibe, right? Yeah. So how do we balance it all? Because you also have the hard press from the schools to, you know, reading list, keep up with the summer reading. We don't want them to slide back in the summer. They've got to keep up scholastically.
Right, and honestly, the kids are not ready yet. So as a parent, I always feel like parenting, we're in the driver's seat, right? We're looking back in the rearview mirror, making sure the kid's safe, having fun, having a good time in their summer activities. And then we're also looking forward, and we're looking for the hazards in the road ahead. And so we as parents, yes, we should kind of, if you're ready, get on board with some of the back to school, whether it's buying the supplies, thinking about clothes or inventory, maybe just doing a light clean out of the kids' closet to see what they might need. Now is a great time to actually think about taking advantage of the early sales. In doing that, you're taking advantage of inventory. The kids will get that hoodie that they want. They're going to get that lunchbox that maybe is really coveted while the inventory is still in place. Mm-hmm. And also, if you're on a tight budget, because it said, on average, Americans are going to spend $700 or more per family on the supplies, the fashion, the school, and everything. If you're on a budget, this way you can kind of plan appropriately as the days kind of tick.
Okay, how do we find the balance of to camp or not to camp? Because I feel like we're kind of like camped out in this area in particular, but then you can also feel like, uh-oh, my kid doesn't have enough planned. And people are juggling something for their kids to do while they maybe are working. How do you just manage it all? But my kid will say to me, can I just have some free time?
Yes, and actually, I really feel it's part of this area, living in the DMV, that camps are a really big deal. It's actually part of the summer culture, and that's just part of a lot of people working and needing some of those hours to be filled and kids to be feeling entertained and enjoying those summer activities, for sure. I actually grew up West Coast, though, where we spent most of our time not in camps and just staring at walls and saying, Mom, I'm super bored. So yes, if you haven't had any summer camps yet and your kid is pining for one, there still are opportunities in August to get something done or maybe to take a short family vacay together to feel like it's camp. Mm-hmm. But the overprescription of having to feel every single minute is also, I feel, maybe one of our downfalls of being where we just feel like we need to do all. We need to get our kid in the best programs. They need to, you know, be reading, whatever. But part of it is also dialing back and realizing that the joys of summer happen beyond these structured activities. It is sitting and having, you know, popsicles drip down your chin at the beach. It is maybe not having a evening time completely overstructured out and to just sit and maybe make s'mores and watch a family movie that wasn't scheduled. Like the unscheduled stuff is also great opportunities to learn.
I also feel like it's a time maybe for to have that unscheduled stuff with their friends, right? Because there's so much scheduled stuff in the school year, or you have the last minute sleepover that, you know, you're not going to have in the school year. We can still do all that, and it's not going to totally wreck us when school starts.
I am a tiger mom in recovery, so I really feel like those spontaneous moments are often the most magical.
Yeah.
So we didn't actually have 4th of July plans, and we just kind of like hobbled it together, and it was one of our most magical nights of summer.
Yeah.
So being a little bit more open, releasing the reins, letting kids be free, and actually through that develop more creativity is sometimes that's the magical that we're trying to reclaim. I know.
I just figured it out for the parents in our area. We're going to give you some homework because you know you need something to do and you need a task, and your homework is to schedule nothing.
Yeah,
and then just figure it out. So the homework is to actually not do anything.
Yes.
Right?
Or schedule the unstructured time. Yeah, schedule the free time.
Exactly. Amy, thank you so much. There's all her social information. She's a wonderful follow. Make sure you do. And you actually don't have to go anywhere, because at 11 o'clock, she's also going to co-host Lion Lunch Hour today. So that's going to be wonderful.
It's going to be fun.
Thank you for being here. So great. All right, still ahead.